sending data when ready. Processing. This may take a few. Human tissue. Color, adipose deposits, and adjacent facial hair stubble indicate that these are human lips and facial skin. Also, I've run the faculty list. The gym teacher at your location during Carl Anderson's tenure was a man by the name of Samuel Tibbetts. And before you ask, yes, Tibbetts' medical records provided his blood type. It's a match with the facial tissue. complete. It's Tibbetts. Fingerprints from his personnel file match the hand. It looks like the torturer got to him before we did.
Thomas speaking.
Thomas, I just wanted to make sure you met me out front when we were done. Didn't want to interfere with the investigation, but...
Not much new here. I'll run a DNA profile.
The trail just ends at a bank of lockers.
Thomas, have you looked inside?
On the way. Who did this to you?
Carl Anderson.
The torturer. Okay, take it easy. Do you know where he is now?
Other man came to Carl away. Left me here to die.
Similar to the pesticide we found on the matchmaker's neck?
An exact match. I've been running an analysis on those samples. It's azinphos methyl and is class 1, highly toxic. Was previously used as an insecticide for all sorts of agricultural crops, now banned for domestic use, and can only be used commercially by permission. This particular formulation includes some other trace chemicals and can be matched to a brand name called Applewell. I've put in a contact to the company to see if we can get a purchaser's list.
Applewell. Apples.
Yes, as I said, it was used on all sorts of agricultural crops. Apples would be one of those.
Yeah, the town of Briar is pretty rural. Any chances there's an apple orchard up there?
I'll get right on it. There are no currently licensed fruit orchards in the town or the surrounding countryside of Briar. But there was one once. Apple Seed Orchard, just outside of Briar on Route 4. In business for 40 years, but closed its doors just 10 years ago after a tremendous outbreak of apple maggots.